Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to this tutorial series about text field text validation. And we are using validation with rejects and of course in Swift. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, in this video, we are going to talk about email validation in a UI text field. But before we do that, let me just remind you that this is a continuation of a previous video and we validated an age text field. So validated if we have a number between 10 and 99. Okay, so it looks something like this. Go ahead and take a look at the link in the description so you may download the starter project. And if you haven't already done so, take a look at the previous video where I set up all of this, what you can see right now, so you can easily dive into email validation. So here we have our Rejects Mania app fired up. It says type in your age. And now let's type in Alex. Now, Alex is not our age, so not a valid age. Great. Now let's type in, let's say, 5. It's still not a valid age. Of course, you could set this to be a valid age, but let's say we want to have our valid age starting only from 10 and ending with 99. So let's type in 10. Valid age. Great. How about 99? Valid age. 100. Not a valid age. So that is how this app works for now. And all of this with the help of our string extension that we have created. Now it's time to validate an email. So let's go further with this project and extend it with an email validation. And that is why now this comes really handy that we have created a validity type, a rejects, and this isValid function on the string extension handles all of this. But we need to still need to type in some code. So let's comment this out. The validity type should be email too. And now as you can see, switch must be exhaustive. So let's add in here another case. And that is for email. Okay, I'm adding the age row value just now because we haven't already created that rejects enum case just yet. So let's do that right now. In a matter of seconds, there we go, and rename this to email. And you want to change this to email too. So in the case of email, we get the rejects email row value. Of course, the row value for enum's case is not unique. Of course, we will change this in just a moment. Okay, and that is basically it. Now, if you want to take a look at the regular expressions cheat sheet, go ahead and here we have a link. Hit command and hover over the link and click on it, and you will be taken to our regular expression cheat sheet from email rejects, and you can read all about it. Now, let's go back to our Xcode project. As you can see, here we have a really simple rejects. So we grab our numbers, where only numbers are allowed, and the minimum number of characters for the string, and that is called the string count, is set to be 2, and the maximum, again, to be 2. Now, this could be changed if you wanted to. Now, for the email, we need another type of rejects, and it's quite complicated to type this out, so I will just grab it from my testing project here, and let's go to extensions, and I will grab it from the email. No peeking now for the next lessons, and let me just paste that in. Now, let's go through this step by step. Now, in these first brackets, we have the sets of characters that are allowed before we have an at character. Okay, so we have letters from A to Z, where capitalized letters 0 till 9, those are the numbers, A to Z, and some special characters too. Now, we have a plus here and an at sign. Now, if you have an email and that is support and that is only small letters or maybe capitalized letters if you wanted to, at, so we have support at rebeloper.com. Let's think about that. So we here we have an at and we want to have rebeloper. So that is again letters, numbers and some special characters. Then we have another plus with dot and com and so on. But with the dot, you need to have these two slashes before the dot because dot is a reserved character in rejects. So you need to be careful what you add in there. So go ahead and this basically is the dot. Okay, so after that, you have A to Z, so dot com, dot org, dot net and so on. And finally, we have the minimum amount of characters and the maximum amount allowed. Okay, and that is it for email. I hope this was quite easy to understand. If not, go ahead and take a look at the cheat sheet for regular expressions here. This is gold if you are looking for rejects. Okay, let's go back to Xcode. Now, let us just change our root view controller's validity type, like the text field's validity type, and let's add in here email. And what luck that it's just simple, we just have to change validity type here and not all the way down here and inside the placeholder of the text field. So let's build and run, and we should have all of this set up. How awesome is that? Of course, we had some preparations to do this, but it's really easy. Type in your email. Great. Let's type in Alex, not a valid email. Okay, let's type in 45, still not a valid email. So let's type in support at rebeloper.com. And it is a valid email. Now you could use this like a checkpoint for, let's say, enabling a button in your registration for a sign up for or maybe even a login for. So if you add in a valid email and this is Rebeloper, it doesn't really matter for the rejects, but that is Rebeloper, that is a real valid email. Okay, and of course you might as well have a small s here if you wanted to, but you could have it capitalized too. And that is it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. We have set up and validated our email address text field. Now, in the next video, we are going to validate our password. So go ahead and take a look at the next video tomorrow. And in the meantime, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you already haven't done so, and hit that notification bell to get notified instantly when I upload new videos just like this. And the next video will be about passwords. So go ahead and check that out too. And as usual, I will see you in the comments down below and in the next one.